Hi, everybody. Today I'm going to talk about migraine headaches. And what I really want to get across to you is what's happening when you get a migraine. Now, I'm not going to talk about the simple, well, we understand that there's a blood vessel problem or things on that level. I really want to get into some nitty gritty here so that you can understand when you understand the mechanisms and you can look for the underlying reasons that those mechanisms are there, you have a hope to make something change and get those migraines to go away. So a little bit here. When you get a migraine, it is a neurovascular event, all right? There is blood vessels, or blood vessels in the brain and around the brain that are really responsible for this the pain that you feel in the covering of the brain. The brain itself, you probably have read, does not actually feel the pain. So this is just a little plastic model of the brain here, and I want to give you a little reference. This is the front, and this is the back. And this area right here, about the size of my thumb, that's the brainstem. This is an area that is responsible for housing a lot of what are called cranial nerves. These are responsible for you moving your face and feeling things and so on. And some of these areas here are really an issue when people have migraines. So a couple things happen here. Number one, neurovascular event. Nervous system to vascular system, all right? There's a loss of control. And the first thing that you will see when there's a loss of control is you might have what's called an aura. And that aura literally is a loss of blood supply to an area in the brain. So if you see spots in one eye, it's a constriction of the blood vessels. So less oxygen getting to the brain, the brain starts to sort of not be able to fire, or it fires kind of in a sporadic way on its own. It loses some control, and you experience that as I'm seeing dots, uh-oh, my headache's about to come, because it's not too much long after that constriction that there's an over-dilation, a rebound, and that's where the pulsing comes, and that's where you start to have the pain occur. So there's a loss of that control mechanism. You know, why are we having constriction and dilation? So that's a key place to look. Now, a lot of medications that are used are meant to maybe control blood pressure, like verapamil or things like that, to try and bring that into a line so you don't have that. Magnesium sometimes is used to try and give some balance to the blood vessels there. The problem is that stuff doesn't always work, right? And if it doesn't, you're probably looking online going, there must be another answer. And that's what I'm trying to give you here. So looking at things neurologically and understanding the state of health in this area here, that brainstem area and the area just above here called the midbrain, and the structures around there can be very, very important to understanding the mechanisms that are specifically going on that are producing your headache. Now, there are a group of doctors out there in the world called functional neurologists or chiropractic neurologists that have training, that know how to look at this sort of thing and know how to evaluate the state of health of this area and gain a good understanding as to what's going on, and then use specific treatments to address those areas. Now, unlike covering up with a medication, we're trying to get to the root cause here and really fix that. Now, there's another thing that I think is very important. That's looking at metabolic issues. The brain controls the body, but the brain is really a slave to the metabolism. So sometimes people are dealing with low-grade chronic inflammation that could be generated from digestion, food sensitivities, imbalances in their metabolism, whatever the case might be. Infections, things like that. It generates inflammation, and the immune system, it's going to be a $5 word coming up here in just a second, the immune system uses chemicals to communicate, kind of like a little walkie-talkie from one white blood cell to the other white blood cell, and the chemicals are called cytokines. And those chemicals have the ability to penetrate through the blood-brain barrier and get into this area and really can cause some havoc, especially in this midbrain area and along here. So an inflammation can be set up in a situation that agitates that area and causes it to really lose its ability to function. So again, find the underlying cause, understand the mechanisms that are in play for that patient, not labeling you as a migraine person, and every migraine person, this is what we do, but why do you have migraines? Why are they perpetuated? those are the questions that should be asked here. And it's very important that you look at these underlying issues and know that your doctor has the expertise to evaluate this, because this is the key here. This is where you can really figure things out for people. So find yourself a doctor who understands how to look at these areas, understands how to appropriately address those problems, and I hope that you find your answers that way. So I appreciate your time. Thank you very much.